Gamers everywhere, I might have some good news for you. Your video game habits just might help you get the job you're looking for.
Oh.
Well, sort of. Reading, writing, and arithmetic. Most of the time when people think of education, these are what they think of. And as a result, schools today are primarily suited to the types of students, and even teachers, who excel in language arts and math. But because of this narrow focus, society is missing out on innovation and productivity from a large pool of people who could be engineers, inventors, technical workers, and tradespeople. What schools are ignoring is spatial reasoning. That's the ability to generate, retain, retrieve, and transform well-structured visual images. It is related to the shape, size, orientation, location, direction, or trajectory of objects and their relative positions. As you can see, you've most likely had your spatial skills challenged and improved by video games.
A current study with my Northwestern University colleagues uses a modified version of one of the most popular games of all time, Minecraft. Our version of the game enables players to control their avatar, not just through the keyboard, but also through voice commands, through physical blocks, and even through eye movements. Of course, we don't know exactly what the results will be, but we expect that games like Minecraft could help children and adults develop practical, spatial, and computational skills for future careers in science, technology, engineering, and math.
While it's necessary to be able to solve equations and understand literature, almost every STEM professional also needs to be able to visualize and build things. Spatial reasoning is a strong predictor of success in visual arts, and in vocational, manufacturing, and technical careers.
Granted, lots of spatially talented students will end up designing rockets without a change in education policy. These students may have been bending metal and building things since they were little, but they also excelled in reading and math. That's how they got admitted to college to get that job. However, the existing system fails to identify many students with spatial strengths. As a consequence, they may miss out on fulfilling and lucrative careers in the trades or in engineering. Instead of building houses or fixing airplanes, lots of these kids just end up wasting their potential.
So, what can policymakers do? Should Minecraft be a standard in classrooms? Well, maybe not, but schools and parents shouldn't discourage activities like gaming either. More realistically, schools should start training spatial reasoning as early as kindergarten to make sure some students don't get left behind.
Throughout school, programs like robotics competitions can help students further develop their skills. Schools, especially vocational and technical schools, should also incorporate hands-on experience and virtual reality learning. Unfortunately, teachers throughout K-12 education tend to have lower spatial and higher verbal and math skills, and thus they may not be able to identify students with excellent spatial abilities. So, teachers also need to be trained to understand, recognize, and value spatial reasoning. Finally, to help maximize higher education opportunities for all students, especially those from lower income families, spatial elements should be incorporated into tests like the ACT and the SAT. While colleges do not undervalue spatial skills, many students who are not already excellent in reading and math don't make it to that level of education.
Now, if you're a kid or a parent out there, none of the research should be construed as a reason to stop studying the three R's. It just means that your computer game hobby could help you develop the skills necessary for some very lucrative and creative careers. At AEI, we care about everybody being able to reach their full potential. If you'd like to learn more about what our scholars are doing in this area, check out the link in the description below. And also, let us know what other topics you'd like AEI scholars to cover on reThINK Tank, and be sure to subscribe for more videos and research from AEI.